Yes, so the next poem we have is The Song of India by V.K. Kukak. So in this poem, the poet, you know, the poem talks of two contrasting situations in India. The poet is counting various objects on which he would like to sing a song. He is counting on many objects and achievements of India on which he thinks that he can sing a song and pay a tribute to motherland. But motherland, you know, he also, the motherland, you know, draws our attention towards that bitter and sad reality of India. So here motherland, that is India, has been personified. It is shown that motherland and the poet, they are in dialogue with each other. So poet is asking the motherland, what object should I sing sing for you, matlab kis aise object ki wo praise kare motherland ke liye, ki he wants to pay tribute to motherland, and which object, you know, which is that one quality that he should start singing of. But motherland says that whereas the poet is talking about the positive side, the motherland draws our attention to bitter side, the sad things, the bad things that are happening, right? So the song of India bursts forth as a cry of agony from the soul of a noble son of Mother India, who sings a song of sympathy for beggars, lepers, toiling millions, ignorant masses, and children of the country. Despite an undercurrent of pessimism, the poem draws substance from optimism that Bharat Mata is destined to achieve its true glory and come out of the quagmire she is stuck at present. The night, no doubt, is dark, but the dawn is not far behind. So, no doubt, this poem is quite pessimistic. It is, but then towards the end, we feel that there is a little hope when we feel that everything will be all right. Right, so this is what the poem is all about. There are two contrasting ideas, you can say, and then there is a dialogue between the motherland and the poet.